Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us talk about feature policy HTTP header. This is a security header, tells the modern browsers which browser features are allowed or denied. Feature policy allows web developers to selectively enable, disable, and modify the behavior of certain APIs and web features in the browser. Feature policy allows you to control which origins can use which features, both in the top level page and in the embedded frames. This is the syntax to specify the feature policy header. So if you see here feature policy, this is a header name, then you can specify the directive, then allow list. The directive specify the feature enabled for the origins in the allow list. The allow list means it's a list of origins that takes one or more of the following values. So you can specify multiple allow list. It should be separated by spaces. Star means the feature will be allowed in this document, the current document, and all the nested browsing contexts, means iframes, regardless of their origin. Then self, that means the feature will be allowed in this document, means the current document, and in all the browsing context in the same origin. So, but it will be blocked for the cross origin. None, this means the feature is disabled in top level and nested browsing context, means it's disabled for all the context, whether for the current page or the nested context. Then SRC, used only with iframe allow attribute, the feature will be allowed in this iframe if the document is loaded from the same origin as the URL in the SRC attribute. If the SRC attribute and the document URL is matching, the feature will be allowed. Next, you can specify the list of origin URLs, example https://example.com, separated by space, means you can have multiple origin URLs separated by space to enable the feature for specific origin. Example, you want to enable only for a specific origins like https://example.com or like https://example1.com, you can specify those values. The value star enables the specific feature for all the origins. Also, the none means this disables the feature for all the origins. The star and none only used alone means we will not be able to combine with other values. But self and SRC can be combined with origins list. Means you can specify additional origins list along with self and SRC. Let us now see the list of feature directives with the feature policy header. There are multiple directives available. The first one is geolocation. This controls whether the current document is allowed to use the geolocation interfaces. So when this policy is disabled, calls to this get current position and watch position throws the exception with error permission denied. Now camera, this controls whether the current document is allowed to use video input devices. So when this policy is disabled, if somebody calls this get user media, will be rejected with this exception, not allowed error, DOM exception. You have multiple other directives. You can see here, autoplay, battery, display capture. Yeah, you can see here other multiple directives. Yeah, you can read through this directives, different directives and their purpose. Let us now quickly see some scenarios. So if you see here, myexample.com having index.html, then myexample.com and myexample1.com having frame.html. Index.html iframing this frame.html from both myexample.com and myexample.com means same origin, and from myexample1.com it's a cross origin. Frame.html accessing the geolocation and user media APIs. If you see this navigator.geolocation.getCurrentPosition, same way navigator.mediaDevices.getUserMedia, both from the myexample1.com and myexample.com. If you see here, no feature policy header is enabled for this index.html. The default behavior is the APIs will be allowed from same document. So means if you are accessing this through index.html, it's allowed. And also the documents from the same origin, means like myexample.com, this frame.html accessing this API, this is allowed. but this will be blocked from the cross origin iframe. So if you see like my example one.com frame.html trying to access the same APIs, but this is blocked. So you will get some exception saying permission denied, DOM exceptions. Now let's see the behavior of setting the value as none. Here I am setting the none for geolocation and camera features. In this case, the access is blocked irrespective of the origin, means blocked for same document. If you access through index.html also blocked, here I'm not showing that. Also like same origin, myexample.com frame.html, it's blocked. And also for the cross origin, myexample1.com frame.html, it is blocked. Now let us see the behavior of setting the value as star. If you see here, I am setting star for geolocation and camera features. In this case, the access is allowed irrespective of the origin. Means allowed for the same document and also allowed for the same origin request and also for the cross origin request. Now let's see the behavior of setting the origin values. Here I am setting myexample1.com for both geolocation and camera APIs. In this case, the access is allowed only for the specific origin. In this case, myexample1.com. If you see here, myexample1.com, frame.html, able to access those APIs. But blocked for all other cases, like same document. If you use the API in the same document, it will be blocked. And also other documents from the same origin. So even this myexample.com, frame.html, it is blocked. And also the cross domains other than the specified in the list, means other than myexample1.com. Now let's see the behavior of combining the self with origin values. If you see here, I am setting self along with the myexample1.com origin for both geolocation and camera API. In this case, the access is allowed from same document, you can access it. Also the access is allowed from the other documents from the same origin. If you see myexample.com/frame.html, able to access the API, and also the specified cross origin domains, myexample1.com frame.html, able to access, but it will be blocked for other cross origin domains. Let's say myexample2.com want to access, it will not able to access it. Let us now quickly see a demo. Let me go here. Yeah, if you see here index.html, this iframing frame.html from both myexample.com, the same origin, and myexample1.com cross origin. Now, if I go to the frame.html, this accessing both geolocation API, if you see here, yeah, geolocation.getCurrentPosition and media navigator.mediaDevices.getUserMedia, the camera API. So this accessing both the APIs. Here I am also using the feature policy API to get some of the detail. Like if you see list of allowed features, you can get like this document dot feature policy dot allowed features. It will print all the allowed features for this document. Then you can even check whether this specific feature is allowed. Like if you see here, like document dot feature policy dot allowed feature geolocation. If the geolocation is allowed, it will return true, otherwise false. Then another one is like even you can check whether this specific feature, it is allowed for this origin. So if you see here like geolocation, then this origin name, it will return true or false. Then another one is you can even find the list of all the available features through this one, document.featurePolicy.features. Now another one is like what are all the origins allowed for specific feature. If you want to find out what are the origins supporting this geolocation, then you can do this document.featurePolicy.getAllowed list of feature. Now right now I'm not setting any headers. If I go here, yeah, this is index.html. For the index.html, I'm not setting any feature policy header. Let me access the index.html now. If I go here, maybe I will go to incognito window, then https://myexample.com/index.html. If you see the pop-up is coming, know your location. So it means it's allowed for one of the scenario. Let's see that. I'm just blocking it, Jay. Yeah, use your camera. That also the pop-up is coming. If I go to this console. Yeah, if you see here, the first frame, it is a same origin frame. the geolocation feature is allowed. So I'm not printing for camera, but that also allowed. But if you go to the second frame, it is a cross origin frame. If you see, the geolocation feature is not allowed because we did not enable any feature policy header. This is the default behavior. Now let us enable the feature policy header as none for both geolocation and camera API. Yeah, if you see here the header, like I'm just adding this header, response.set header for this index.html. Feature policy, geolocation none, then camera also none. Let us quickly test this. If I go here, let me stop and start it. Okay, let me access https myexample.com/index.html. Now if you see, there is no pop-up displayed to request the permission. So if I go to the console, yeah, so the first frame also it is false, means it's not supported because we have specified as a none. So irrespective of the origin, it will be blocked. So same case for the cross origin iframe. Let us now enable the feature policy header as star for both geolocation and camera API. So let me go and enable that. Let me comment out this. I'm enabling this. If you see here, feature policy, geolocation star, then camera also star. Let me quickly restart the server. This is fine. Okay, access https myexample.com/index.html. If you see now, the pop-up is displayed. Let me block this, that's fine. Let me go and inspect this. Console, yeah, if you see here, the geolocation feature is allowed for true for the first frame and also for the second frame because we specified star. Irrespective of the origin, so the API will be supported. Let us now enable the feature policy header with the specified origins for both geolocation and camera API. Yeah, let me comment out this. If you see here, I'm going to enable this feature policy, geolocation, this specific origin, myexample1.com, and also for camera, myexample1.com. Now let's see the behavior. Let me quickly restart this server. Now, let me access myexample.com/index.html. Fine, the pop-up is displayed now. Let me block. Yeah. If I go and inspect it, go to console. If you see the behavior for the first frame, it is not allowed. It's false. But the second frame, it is true. It means it is allowed only for the specific origin because we specified the origin as myexample1.com. So it's allowed. But the first iframe is from the same origin, myexample.com. But it's not allowed. Let us now enable the feature policy header with the self and specified origin for both geolocation and camera API. So let me comment out this, enable this. If you see here, I am enabling self and myexample1.com for both geolocation and this camera API. Let us see the behavior now. Let me quickly restart the server. Okay, let me open this myexample.com index.html. If you see the pop-up is coming now, let me block, let me inspect it. Console, if you see here, like for the first frame, it is allowed, true. And also the second frame also, it's allowed. Why? Because we enabled self means same origin documents. And also we specified the origin, additional origin as myexample1.com. So it's allowed for both the cases. Delivering the policy as a HTTP response header applies it to the page and the embedded browsing context within it, means all the iframes. You may wish to have a different policy applied to each of these iframes. You can enable features on specific iframes. Let me comment out this header. Now I need to enable the access for specific iframe. Let me show that. Go to index.html. So if you see here, I am having two iframes. One is same origin, another one is with cross origin. So I'm going to add this specific configuration, allow. So let me add here, allow, I am saying allow geolocation slash camera for this specific iframe and the same context also. So it will be inherited to the child pages also. Let us see the behavior now. Let me quickly restart this server. Okay, let me access the URL here. https://myexample.com/index.html. Yeah, if you see the pop-up is displayed now. Now let me inspect and go to console. Yeah, if you see here the first frame, the geolocation feature is allowed. It's true also for the second frame. If you see the first frame, because this is the default behavior, the same origin frames will have the access to the API. But for the second frame, the access is enabled through the allow attribute of the iframe, the geolocation and camera API access. You can refer the feature policy browser compatibility matrix here. The header directives are not completely supported by all the browsers. Feature policy HTTP security header allows us to control the external iframed resources accessing the browser features. The feature policy header has now been renamed to permissions policy in the spec. We should be using permissions policy instead of feature policy in the future. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.